In the past few years, the usage of drones has dramatically increased. Miniature surveillance helicopters are being used by British military intelligence forces in Afghanistan. The remotely controlled devices send camera footage and pictures to the troops on the ground. The 1x4-inch drone, known as the Black Hornet NANO Unmanned Air Vehicle, can be piloted manually or it can be programmed using GPS coordinates. It weighs less than an ounce, reaching speeds of up to 22 miles per hour. The Black Hornet can travel for up to half an hour and has a range of around a half mile. Sergeant Christopher Petherbridge from the Brigade Reconnaissance Force stationed in Afghanistan said, "We used it to look for insurgent firing points and check out exposed areas of the ground before crossing, which is a real asset. It is very easy to operate and offers amazing capability to the guys on the ground." The military contract for the drones specifies that 160 of them will be supplied and maintained by Marlborough Communications. The drones were initially designed by the company Prox Dynamics in Norway for search and rescue procedures.
Black Hornet is designed for surveillance for ourselves on the ground as infantiers. Therefore, we need to get eyes into any VPs, vulnerable areas, that is, or into compounds or anything to rise an occasion or we don't deem safe. We'll get the Black Hornet up. It's got three cameras basically. It's got one on the eyes, one on the nose, and one on the mouth. The one on the eyes looks like directly out the front. The one on the nose will give you a 45 degree angle, and the one on the mouth will look directly below the Black Hornet. So it'll give you three different camera angles at any one time. It's also got a camera in there, so it gives you stills. So if in that compound, you want to take a snap or anyone in there to then for evidence for future ops or anything like that. Basically, you take a snap, where the crosshairs are on the camera will give you a 10-figure grid of that location, just in case it was to happen out on the ground and you need to call in anything at that time, you then got a 10-figure grid to then call in accurate fire. No, I'm not a big fan of toy helicopters out like that, I'm a bit too old. However, using this is no different to playing on an Xbox, playing on a PS3 with the controllers, you know. Most kids these days and most people are all familiar with Xboxes and PS3s. So if you can operate one of them, you can operate a Black Hornet. Charging, it'll charge back into the space station when you put the Black Hornet to sleep. However, you get 20 minutes flight time on it. So in an ideal world, 5 minutes to get onto the task, 5 to 8 minutes on task with the surveillance, and then 5 minutes to then return the Black Hornet back. However, once the Black Hornet knows, because it's got a database in there, that it's running low, it will then ask you on the display panel if you want to return to home.